Hey everybody, this is Mike and I'm back after a very, very long hiatus. I decided I want to start recording stuff again. And I figured I'd start with this. This is something simple and short that we'll be doing. It's like, you remember Descent, right? Like, I did that game, which is like the 3D ship movement stuff. And corridors and stuff. This is a single player version of that. That's, well, obviously inspired by... You can't even deny it at this point, And it's like procedurally generated and a bit of a roguelike too, so it's pretty fun. Pretty short game, but you know, pretty fun all the same. So I really looked online to see if I could unlock all the ships through some kind of profile or something. I couldn't do it. Doesn't matter though, because I still have like the best railgun ship, so what the fuck else am I ever gonna do? Who even knows? So it's either standard gunship, which doesn't really tell you the stats, but this one will be more accurate and is a little bit slower and has lower fire rates, so that's what we're doing. I'm not gonna read this, fuck this. Just, there's a story to it and it's all throughout text. It's kind of like, you know, your typical indie game kind of storyline, I guess. I mean, honestly, what we're here for is to play a game, so you read this on your own time, I don't give a shit. This literally looks kind of like the Descent craft. Now, the game is like a weird mix of like modern 3D graphics and like, I think it's called Voxel or something. So yeah, we start normally. It's like kind of like the textures look all pixely, but things are like, I don't know, it's hard to describe. Oh yeah, you can spin around as usual, so if you're getting sick, then fuck you, I don't care. And so we start with impact rifle. You have like two primary weapons you can switch to. And then two secondary weapons you can switch to with missiles and shit, but I don't have any of that. Also, I've played through this game several times. Every game is a new experience because it's procedurally generated. So, which is good and bad. I'll talk about that in a bit. So this is a repair kit. This is how you repair yourself in this game. So my health is the green bar at the top. Obviously, I have to start with 100 life. Not really necessary to do. And this is like they have like chests in this game. I just picked up nanites and plasma ammo. So the kind of ammo I'm using right now is autocannon, which is like bullets, and energy ammo. The dude over here. There's not very much variation in the difficulty level. There we go, now we have an impact rifle. This is a brutal one, so you can see the stats kind of on the side. I'm already using an impact rifle and mine is better. Actually, this one has more damage. I'll take that one. Whoops, that's not the pickup key. So I hold this and I pick it up, and there we go. And here's a hull I can take. This is so on the left there is what hull I have now. I have like a standard hull. This one, if I pick up this one, it would have like more secondary ammo but less primary ammo and really not much of a difference. Honestly, the hulls are kind of crap in this game. I'm not a big fan of them. Oh yeah, and there's an inventory system since I've been picking stuff up, so you can sell my stats and missile types and fun stuff like that. And here I can change my weapons into something else. So if I really wanted to, I could make an impact rifle into a smart gun, which I think I'll do, because I already have I have two impact rifles, so I might as well. Except I need a lot more nanites. What's a strafer? I'll do. Stores more ammo of all types, but has average ammo. Sorry, armor, not ammo, no, fucking ammo. And the armor is crap for a very good reason. It's because, like, you see these repair kits I'm picking up, they always heal 25, no matter what. It's not actually, it should be 25% if you ask me, but it's actually 25 hull. Unless the guy has changed it, which I don't think he has, because it hasn't really been updated since this game came out. This is a Game Boy. It's actually like a text log thing, who cares. Story, it's basically you play through it several times, you get a bit of a story, and I've paid attention to it, not at all. So that's how I work. What was I going on about? Oh yeah, the hull is a bit crap in this game, because it's just like, if you have more health, it still doesn't matter, because you're going to repair all the same. And so, like, who really cares about that? You might as well pick the thing with, like, more ammo or something. I don't know, it's not something I particularly care about. Engines are pretty nice. Obviously, railguns and shit like that is pretty nice. I forget what this is like, I already have basically, like, it's like a tier 2 weapon, I think, and it's, like, still pretty good. This is an autocannon. Let's try this guy out. Actually, I already have an autocannon. That's what this was. Okay, never mind. I just tried to equip it. I got the clumsy one. Oh, let's put the unknown back on. Alright. Do we have anything? So we could just, like, we could just make a shit ton of autocannons, essentially. Or, sorry, smart guns. Smart guns are kind of crap, though, if I remember. I don't know. I haven't played this in a while, okay? Just chill out. Dude, I haven't recorded any, like, for anyone who comes later and watches this, it's been like fucking a year since I've recorded anything. I streamed a lot, but I didn't record anything. But I've been wanting to get back into this shit, so I figured I'd do it with a game that I can be mildly bad at. With railguns, obviously. Oh, this is a Razor Impact Rifle. This one has more accuracy, but that doesn't really matter, and these guys are firing missiles at me. So I'm gonna just look at... Oh god. I think one of them hit me. My health is at 72 now. So overall, this game, I think, is fairly nice. The way I would best describe it is it has a ton of potential. Unfortunately, I don't think it's received too many updates. But it's not a fair thing to say because it only came out like a month or two ago. Oh, here we go, Firebolt. And I mean, there was like the holidays and shit, and the developer has actually been fairly active on the forums, of the Steam forums or whatever. So I think he is doing stuff with it, and he has added, I think, challenge rooms recently. Firebolt is basically shit, so this is what Firebolt does. So let's go right back to the railguns. Even though the ship has more accuracy, it's kind of trash. Because I would say, my opinion of this game is that I don't think there's nearly enough, like variety for something that's supposed to be completely random all the time. Brutal autocannon. I think I want it to be here. Yeah, this one does way more damage. Like, right now I've been picking up basically, like, similar weapons, which I can't really say much because it's, like, whatever. That's another kind of missile, which I haven't been using missiles at all. So the map is pretty nice. I think Total Biscuit talked about it or something. He's like, oh, I love the map. But that's one of the things you can definitely say is, like, you know, unlike most, 3D space games. Oh, this is a challenge room. Okay, I've never done one of these. Okay, I'm getting my ass kicked by these things. Because I actually do not recognize this guy over here. I think it's a boss. Yeah, it's a mini boss. Okay. That would explain a lot. And there's some mini railgun guys, which we have not faced yet. But they're dead, so it's all good. Alright. We got a plasma buff. Okay. That's also new. Okay, maybe I shouldn't complain about the lack of variety, because there's variety. Okay, I got like 41 health, so I'm gonna use some of my healing packs. So you guys see that it's gonna heal basically 44. So 25, unless I'm wrong. In which case, I don't know, my fault. Let's try a marksman thing here. Fortunately, my inventory is kind of getting full. So we have to decide on some things we don't want anymore. So yeah, now we get, like, we already have like 12 out. You got basically have 12 slots. And I think, yeah, all these weapons and stuff use like fucking 2 slots. So I gotta basically now do the tough decision of choosing something to get rid of. And you know what? I don't care about hulls, so whatever, I'll equip it, okay? We now have a bomber hull, okay? With 99 HP, so my autism is flaring up right now. Alright, let's see how this one fires. That one's trash, but whatever. Alright, let's try this thing. Oh, cool, it's pew pew pew. And we want this thing, except our inventory is full, so we gotta get rid of something else. But you see, some of these things are for crafting, so, like, if I want the clumsy firebolt, which I really don't, I'll just take that one. Might as well take the better one. You know, it may look like that this game contains a lot of crafting, like emphasis around the crafting system, but trust me, it doesn't. I'm just terrible, and I'm taking so long to look at all this stuff. Also, there's an acceleration key. I'm not sure why I haven't been using that this entire time. Looks like we're near the end of this. I mean, that's the reactor right there. Yeah, like in True Descent style, there's like a reactor at the end of every stage. I kind of like the music. But the ship is slower than molasses, so you know what? I want, like, some nice engines. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go back because I think there's another green door over here. And so, I mean, there really isn't a point in exploring because, I mean, technically in the later stages I'll probably get something anyways. So I don't know why I care. I really don't, actually. But no, actually I want nanites, so fuck you, I want to explore. How about that, okay. So, I mean, there's random dead ends and stuff. I'll show you how. I don't think we've seen a dead end so far, so. I mean, this game handles really well. Oh shit, the flamethrower, we want that shit. Where is that? Okay, here's the flamethrower, okay. You guys ready? You guys ready for the flamethrower? Literally W mouse one, let's go. It wouldn't be something I'd... Yeah. Eat flamethrower, and I'm dying. Okay, we just flamethrowed the shit out of these guys. My inventory is full again. Whatever, I'll just use this guy immediately. Oh shit, it's another challenge room. This is the stupidest video I've ever made. Already. I don't know how it's taken, like, hasn't even been one part I've ever devolved into fucking with flamethrowers. Alright, let's go back to railguns. We want to pick these up because these expire after a little bit of time. Did we kill everything in this room? Oh yeah, we did. Alright, let's see what we get now. We get literally nothing. Oh, there's a cruel pulsar. I don't know what makes it... We already have a pulsar, though. We were using that earlier. So, can we make anything good with this flamethrower? A marksman plasma caster. Semi-automatic overheats, hold for charge shot. You know what, that sounds pretty good. But what am I combining it with? Firebolt and flamethrower. Alright, let's put that together. Alright, now we have a plasma caster. Yeah, it's like literally like a fusion cannon kind of a thing. Did I ever explore everything here? Yeah, it looks like that's it. So, dude, it was totally worth it to come back here, because now we have like... the equivalent of the fusion cannon. Alright, let's just blast through this. So, some other mechanics that probably didn't explain that well. So nanites are required to... like, nanites are just shit that enemies drop and I have no idea where I'm going. Where was the reactor core? It goes that way. Yes, it is this way. Now I recognize where I'm going. Sorry, what was I going on about? I don't know. I never completely forgot. Because I have ADD. But yeah, so... I mean... I was saying before, I think that the variety isn't that great in this game, because... honestly, like, you know, they got, like, basically one of every weapon, but they don't upgrade particularly well. I like this railgun thing that I have upgrades like crap. And I'm just gonna shoot this guy from over here. Because why even go into the... because I think what it does is it fucking prevents me... it locks me into the room if I go into here, so I have to not go into the room. There's some turrets here. This thing actually ain't half bad. But, like, you know, you got the fusion cannons, but the weapons upgrade into basically trash a lot of the time, I find. Because there's only, like... they basically have, like, three tiers of weapons. And I think that the impact rifle is, tier 2, I don't know. That's the first weapon that I've had this entire time. Alright, here's a standard hull that has slightly more HP on it. I mean, who really gives a fuck at this point? Holy shit, I have to get rid of a lot of stuff. Alright, let's put the bomber hull back up. Fuck that. Why can't I have that guy? Oh, because I fucking have a standard hull now. You know, there's these fucking strafer hulls. I want them, but it, like, the game won't let me. You know what, fine. We don't really want this. Yeah, fuck the pulsar, we don't want that shit. So now we have a flux drive component, let's touch it. And it makes a portal thing, so let's go in. And obviously if you leave anything behind then you're fucked, because you can't go back for it. Alright, so here now I have, I can choose one thing from this list. I can either have auto repair, get a bit of regeneration when I'm low. Slightly reduces max HP. If you've listened to me so far, as I said, the repair bots do 25, like a static amount of HP. So who cares about max HP? I mean, I guess, like, if you're in a room and, like, you really need it, you don't have time to repair a bot, I guess it's fine, but, you know, it's trash. Marksman, accuracy and damage is slightly increased, but fire rate is decreased. Bullet, you get some bullet ammo regeneration. Oh, fuck it, let's go auto repair. Because I already have, like, maximum... Like, has accuracy really been an issue here? Apparently it has, because I'm at 60% accuracy. So let's go next level. Oh, yeah, and, you know, we started at level 0 and then... Because it's the game is called Sublevel 0. I mean, as I said, I think it's a good game. I think it's still about... You see, now my health is 91. I still think it's a really nice game, though. But, I mean, that's just me, I guess. You know. I think it really needs some more updates, because I think it, as I said, you know, that especially with like procedural level generation, it kind of gets repetitive, because it's essentially actually cookie cutter is what I should, it's a better word for it. I mean, if you played like something like Diablo 3, then you'll know exactly what I'm talking about, and the flaws of such a system. And here you go. So this is part of one of the things with the procedural generation here. Is that sometimes this will be a door somewhere else, sometimes it won't. And that's how it basically essentially does dead ends in this game. So the doors are basically just blocked off. I mean, that's not problematic or anything, but I mean, there needs to be a little bit more variety in the rooms, because this is another room which I'm familiar with. Well, okay, the problem isn't that I'm familiar with it, but like, it's like, you know, I think you'll notice it repeating occasionally sometimes too. My fire rate appears to be even lower. I don't even know why. Alright, let me get in there. Oh, no, the ship disappeared, except... I don't know, weapons won't disappear, so it doesn't really actually matter that much. Anyways, it's another one of these things, so... Whatever. I'm not reading up. We're here for video games. We're not here for anything else. Oh, I don't think I... No, those are, like, little things here. Actually, I'm not completely familiar with everything now, because I think he's actually updated. So, you know, as I said, this entire time I've been bitching about various things, and I actually don't think it applies anymore. All right, I want to get rid of something. Actually, you know, I have like 2 dumbfire missiles here. The cold dumbfire is literally doesn't make a difference, so drop that guy. The stats are literally the same. What the hell did I... What? Apparently, when it's not in my inventory, it doesn't actually count as a thing that I can have. Alright, there we go. It doesn't count towards my inventory, despite the fact that I have it equipped. There's a lot of shit in this room. I think I'm a fucking sniper guy. Yeah, let's just go in there. Be man mode. So, this secondary weapon I have has a heat meter in the center there, and I can fire rapidly if I want to. A savage laser. Absolutely savage, this laser. Let's look at this guy. Oh, that thing sucks ass. I want to get rid of that. Actually, there's a crafting opportunity. Let's go see what that was. Oh, railguns. Oh. Railguns. Alright, we'll do that. Because honestly, I don't think you guys would expect anything else from me. Even though we're not gonna... I want to get that fucking haul first. You know what? I'm gonna get that haul first. I don't have to carry around all this fucking shit all the time. So, let's get the strafer haul then. Now we have a haul that's very good at strafing. No, that's not actually what it does. It stores more ammo of all types, but has average armor. But now I have 113 armor. Alright, did I want the plasma caster? I don't remember. Actually, I can take it anyways, who cares? I have a laser. I need to get rid of that. I want the plasma caster, I think. Alright, now that I'm done being trash and fucking taking an hour and a half to craft everything. So when we get to 750 nanites, we'll make the fucking railgun, alright? Alright! I think you guys would like think I'm like sick or changed or something if I didn't was making fucking railguns every time. I don't care, I'm meh. Alright. So I look down here. It's a box. Full of trash. Do I have like an Oh, get out of here, you piece of shit. Alright. What? Oh, this is a dead end, alright. So we actually have to go another way. So we can kind of look at our map and go, okay, where did we fuck up? And actually, this is, we're actually done with this area, so we gotta go back, all the way back. So if you like backtracking, this game's for you. And I'm not criticizing, it's actually, it's legit pretty good. I mean, if it gets updated even more, I might even say it's a must-buy. But it honestly needs the updates. To add some more variety and shit. So, I mean, I totally missed this here. When I went through here the first time. Yep, blows the fuck up. Oh, here we go, we have a grenade. Grenades are pretty fun, so we can switch that weapon type. And let's use a grenade now. So, the missiles are right now just dumbfired. They're basically essentially the equivalent to the concussion missiles that you saw in Descent. What you're about to see now, the first enemy I'm seeing, I'm going to use it on. There we go, now we have a bit of a variation terrain for a change. Alright, so there's this guy, and so I can, look at this, I can bounce off the wall. I can do like a skill shot, look at this. Except it's really difficult too, because it's a fucking unstable terrain. Oh no, 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 that's not bouncing. Dude, can't I be fucking good for once? Holy shit, get off my dick. Yeah, okay, yeah, we're now done, because now we just met an enemy that's really annoying. Alright, so that I was just showing an example of what a bad player would be doing in this game. And, yeah. Alright, so I'm pretty sure that the game isn't paused, by the way, when I'm looking at the map, so you can get fucked by something if you want to. I mean, it's up to you. This game is limitless in the amount of ways you can screw yourself. So these guys are annoying as balls because they kind of rush at you. And they hurt you. Oh yeah, did I mention that ramming in this game is a thing? I don't know why the hell you'd want to do it, but there's actually a ship specifically meant for ramming. Because if you haven't noticed, things blow the fuck up when I destroy them, so... You know. I'm gonna equip that guy, because that's a brutal dumpfire missile. It does 4 more damage, which may make the difference between life and death. Alright. We're going here. So we have our blue key. Yes, there are keys. I told you, it's like basically, you know, throw back. Okay, I'm gonna ram this guy. Look at that guy. Oh, that shit, that guy got rammed to fucking death. I'm the biggest rammer alive. Alright. Rusty fireball, fuck that. Did I get enough for the railgun yet? No, we don't have enough. Alright, I think we need to heal ourselves just slightly. I know I haven't been paying attention if it still does 25, so let me see where it stops at. 25. Yeah, and it stops. Okay. So yeah, getting more armor is still absolutely useless in this game. One of my biggest disappointments. That's another flamethrower. Ow. You can get your fast-paced gameplay. I'm just with the slowest ship fucking alive, because it's the railgun ship, so naturally it's the slowest one. This makes sense, you know? Alright, how much do I have now? I wish I had a nanite counter. There, I probably do, and it's right there. So I don't have enough. You know, it's an excellent game, because when you make wishes, it grants any wish you want. So my one, but only one wish, so I wanted a nanite counter. Instead of solving, like, world hunger or some shit, then we got a fucking nanite counter. But if you buy this game right now, any wish you want, it will grant it. Alright. By the way, I'm not being paid to tell you to buy the game, so... Do whatever the fuck you want. Before you think I'm selling it or some shit. I wish I was paid. God. Dude, I'd sell it so hard. Hey, EA, if you're listening, need money. Thanks. Actually, that's a joke, because actually they do pay people to do that stuff. I forgot about that. Apparently Battlefront 2 was doing, sorry, no, it wasn't Battlefront 2. Battlefront 2 is the good one. I'm sorry, that was heresy. Whatever their new shitty Star Wars Battlefront game was, it was fucking garbage. And they actually paid, like, I think some YouTubers and famous celebrities to basically praise the game. So, you know, it's really depressing and sad when my jokes actually are true. You know? That EA actually does do shit like that. You're asking why I don't go into there, and that's why. So now I don't have to get hit by any of these lasers. I'm gonna run out of ammo eventually. But not today. Actually, where's my ammo for this? Oh yeah, that's right, it's on the left there. Alright, let's get in here. Inventory is full. Alright, let's heal ourselves. Now, I'm pretty sure that the healing doesn't go on to the next level, so we're gonna just let it do its thing. And also, the game, no, it's not paused, so, you know, that's something interesting to note. Alright, so we can get clumsy railguns. That's all we can get. That's fine. Did I craft it? I may have not pressed okay. Okay, now I crafted it. I just got rid of my impact rifle. It consumed my impact rifle. That's fine. You know what? Railgun, you know, is still a good idea. So, I think I combined, like, two energy weapons to make a bullet weapon. Don't fucking ask how. Now we have railguns. But you know what? This is actually the upgrade for the fucking impact rifle. I forgot about that, actually. Dude, it's been so long since I played this. Bullet weapons do more damage, but it decreases damage by plasma energy. I can't take damage from my own weapons or exploding enemies, but your maximum HP is nearly halved. Okay, you know, that was gonna be my other complaint, is these upgrades literally usually don't really do much, but apparently now they do, because this is a new one. Or maybe I've just never seen it before, I don't even know. That's interesting, though. I don't want to have my HP, so fuck that. That's for ramming, though. This is totally for ramming people. I mean, because HP doesn't matter, as I've said, so... fire rate is decreased. I think I should do this one, but on the other hand, I think I should do this one, because this one will make my... I don't know. Let's do bullet specials. Fuck it.